Currently, the standard is to do a fish analysis on the one hand for evaluation of the chromosomes, but right now we are more and more testing for specific genes. So far, the European-wide standard, also according to the ERIC consortium, is with Sanger technique, but more and more centers also use next-generation sequencing. The problem is, since we detect more and more single CLLs as carrying these TP53 disruption by NGS, we don't yet have the data what is the outcome of those patients. Is there a certain cutoff when it's important to switch from chemoimmunotherapy to novel agents if, for example, only 1% of the CLLs has carrying TP53 disruption? Right now, with the Sanger technique, the cutoff is around 7% of the CLL cells, and this is significant for us, and this would be an indication, for example, to start frontline therapy with ibrutinib. At diagnosis, I would discuss that with the patient, because outside of clinical trials, if the patient is asymptomatic, even the presence of TP53 disruption has no consequences with regard on treatment initiation. Every patient should be tested before treatment initiation, meaning before frontline therapy, and if he was negative for TP53 and the patient requires relapse treatment, he should be tested again and again at the next treatment. So this is an examination which has to be done for every treatment decision.